Hello everyone, welcome to Optiongig. This is your host Vivek Somani. I am an option trader by passion and a full-time software executive by profession. If you want to learn how to generate consistent monthly income trading options while working full-time in your day job, then join me in this journey. In today's session, we're going to talk about options expiration, exercise and assignment. The objective of this session is to give you enough information around this whole process so that you become comfortable with the expiration and assignment. Okay, all right. Why we want to do this? Because for a new trader, options expiration is always a mystery. We don't know what's going to happen during expiration. So through this session, we're going to dive deeper into it to understand. Also, an assignment can be a scary phenomenon if you do not understand the basics. Some people are scared, and if they get assigned, they suddenly panic in terms of what do we do? I got assigned so many shares. So what are the steps available to mitigate that? In this session, we'll break down the entire process to give you full understanding of how the process works so you can make your own decisions. You have all the information available to make those decisions. Okay, let's refresh our basic concepts. The first one is, we all know that options have a finite lifetime. All the options will expire on a particular day. We trade mostly the options that expire around 45 to 50 days. Other thing to note is that options are derivatives of stock, and hence they are not regulated by SEC, but they are regulated by a different regulator called Option Clearing Corporation. The reason why I brought up this Option Clearing Corporation is that you will see what role does this play in the overall assignment process. Okay, so I talked about two terms, exercise and assignment. Let's understand what's the difference between these two terms. Exercise is initiated by option buyers for in the money options. So as an option buyer, if my option is in the money and if I want to exercise my right, whether it is a call right or it's a put right, as a buyer, you will exercise the right on the option. But an assignment is as an option seller. The seller is assigned the option which is exercised by the buyer. So seller has to deliver on the contract which are assigned to them. Those are the option contract. Now let's talk about Option Clearing Corporation. OCC, it is the world's largest derivatives clearing house. It provides services to all the option exchanges in US. As of now, we have 15 or so exchanges on which options are being traded. They all are a part of the consortium of OCC, and OCC provides services to all those option exchanges. OCC operates under the jurisdiction of SEC because SEC regulates equity. For equity options, OCC use the jurisdiction of SEC, and for future options, they use the jurisdiction of CFTC. OCC issues all the options and control the whole assignment and exercise process. That is why they are of interest in today's session. Okay, continuing on OCC, what do? They guarantee all the trades by acting as a counterparty to it. They are not the other party. It's important to understand. For example, if you are selling an option, it is not the OCC which is buying that option, but OCC stands in between you and the buyer of the option as an intermediary to guarantee that both the parties, the buyer as well as seller, they will do good on their own part of contract. So OCC acts as an overseer to ensure that everyone keeps their part of the bargain. They are directly participant in every option trade, but they are not the buyer or the seller. All right, let's see how the overall process works. So to understand how the process works, we have to see what happens when a buyer wants to buy a particular option. So when a buyer wants to buy a particular option, they send a payment to OCC. So what you see in middle here is OCC. So this is OCC. And when a buyer wants to buy an option, they send a payment to OCC. Then OCC directs that payment to seller. Seller will write an option and send that option contract to OCC. OCC will then pass over the option contract to the option buyer. And this is how the whole process completes. The buyer sends a payment, OCC wires the payment to option writer. Option writer writes up the contract. The contract is sent to the buyer. But through electronic means, everything happens in a split second. Okay, let's talk of option expiration. When does options expire? Most of the options expire after the third Friday of the contract month for monthly options. In this session, we'll only talk about monthly options, though there are weekly options also on multiple tickers. For just to keep it simple, today we'll only focus on monthly options. So monthly options expire on third Friday of every month. So if you want to avoid going through the process of assignment, then you must close all your positions before expiration. So when is the last trading day for those options? So for equity options, the last trading day is third Friday of the month, because after this all the options expire. But for index option, the last trading day is, it's a third Friday, or if it is a holiday, then it is Thursday for American options. For European, it is a third Thursday. Important thing to understand is that there are two type of options, American and European. That do not mean that European options are the one that trade on European exchanges, or that those are from European companies. No, that's not the case. We'll see it later what's the difference between American and European type options. So American options are the options that can be exercised any time during the options lifetime. So even though the options expiration is on after third Friday of a month, but theoretically an option buyer can choose to exercise their option at any time throughout this option period. So most options that we deal with are American style options. European style options are the ones that can be exercised only on the last day of the options period. It means those cannot be exercised before. SPX, NDX, Forex are such options. So if you deal in these index options, the exercise will happen only on the third Friday of a month. So you don't have to worry about early option assignment. There's a concept of option automatic exercise. Most of the broker, they will go through an auto exercise provision, because they will assume that as a buyer, you would want to exercise your option if it is profitable. And most of the brokers will exercise the options automatically if there is any option that is more than 1 cent in the money. But if you do not want to exercise an option because maybe the exercise fee is much higher than the profit that you'll be making as an option buyer, then you must call your broker and tell them that you do not want to exercise the option. Okay, how does the whole exercise and assignment process works? So stay with me on this one. This is an interesting one. It's a call holder, means a call buyer. And if they want to exercise an option, they send a notice to his broker. Either they call a broker, and or if it is already on the last day of expiration, broker will automatically exercise the option. What a broker does, through its admin department, broker sends a notice of exercise to OCC. Now, this is where OCC plays a big role in terms of the assignment process. OCC, once they receive that from a broker that their customer wants to exercise their option, OCC then randomly selects a member. Member means member exchanges, other brokers, who is short in the exercised call and assigns them with this exercise. Again, point to note is that OCC will randomly select any broker and assign them with this option. Broker will pick up and randomly select any customer, or sometimes the broker select the customer on first in first out basis and assign the option to that particular customer. So since it is a call option, when the broker is assigning that option to the customer, so customer will have to deliver the shares. The share goes to broker. Broker takes the shares and sends the shares to OCC. Then OCC delivers the shares to the initial broker from where this call originated, and the broker will deliver the share to their customers. Again, let's understand. A call option buyer sends a notice of exercise to its broker. Broker sends the notice over to OCC. OCC will randomly select any broker and then assign that option contract to that broker. That broker will then assign that to any of their customers who are short the call. The customer will deliver the shares to broker. Broker will deliver the shares to OCC. OCC will take and give the shares to the call holder broker, and call holder broker will deliver the shares to the call holder. This is how the overall process works. The thing to note is that it is random. So it means the person, the third party which was involved as a buyer on your option, may not be the party whose options are being assigned to you. It is always random. Next, settlement. How does the settlement work? There are two types of settlements. One is called physical settlement. To settle the assignment process, you have to deliver the underlying equity. For example, if you sold a covered call and the option is ITM, that is in the money, and you are assigned on that call option that you have to deliver the shares through your broker platform. Most of the option trades in small accounts are physically settled. We will see what's the other type of settlement. The another type of settlement is called cash settlement, and it applies if it is impossible to deliver an underlying security, and then it's only cash settled. So options on most stock indexes like SPX, which is index on S&P 500, RUT, which is an index on Russell, and NDX, which is an index on NASDAQ, those are all cash settled because you cannot buy an index. You may buy an ETF on index. On SPX, there's a SPY ETF, but you cannot buy an index itself. So the options on the index are cash settled because you cannot deliver an index. So what happens upon assignment, the broker will update the account balance by the amount of the profit or the loss depending on the trade. So that's called cash settlement. So this was the overall process of expiration, assignment, and the settlement. Again, just to recap, though the options can be exercised any time during the options period, please understand that most of the exercise happens during the last week of expiration. Why? Because by exercising earlier, the option buyer tend to lose the extrinsic value that is still remaining in the contract. So until the extrinsic value is really small, there is a little chance of option being exercised, because why would the option buyer like to lose the money which is still remaining in an option contract? Okay, now let's understand, am I at a risk of assignment? And this applies only to the American style options, because European style options do not get exercised before the expiration period. But American style options can be exercised throughout the option period. So how do you understand whether I'm at risk of assignment or not? Like I said, short options, and today we're going to only talk about American style options, they can be exercised anytime, but the early assignment risk happens only in the below cases. In case of a short puts, if it is deep in the money with a very low extrinsic value, that could be one reason of an early assignment. Or if it is a short call, it could be a risk at early assignment if there is an upcoming dividend. And we will see some examples of it. For example, this is a deep in the money put option with little extrinsic value. The stock price is at 50, your put strike price is at 55, and today the put is being traded as $5.03. It means the extrinsic value in this option is 3 cents. So since it has very low extrinsic value, it is at a high risk of assignment. Whoever has sold this put may be assigned early because it's a very less extrinsic value remaining in this put option. By exercising the put option, the option buyer is losing only 3 cents of an extrinsic value, and he may be okay to take that risk. Let's take an example of in the money call options. In this case, the stock price is at 50. The call strike is at 45. It means it's in the money already. But the current call option is being traded at $5.02. That means the extrinsic value is just 2 cents. Again, the buyer of this call option has a high probability that he will choose to exercise this option, because by exercising, it tends to lose only 2 cents of extrinsic value. Not much. Now, let's take an example of a short call. The other case in which a short call is at risk of assignment is if the amount of dividend is more than the extrinsic value. For example, the previous one that we looked at was when the extrinsic value is very low. This one we are looking at where the extrinsic value is still higher, but it is less than the amount of dividend. So in this example, the stock price is at 50. The call strike is at 48, but the call price right now is $2.82. That means the extrinsic value is 82 cents. The call buyer may not exercise this just based on the extrinsic value, because he or she will tend to lose 82 cents on this trade. But there is a dividend which is upcoming on this particular ticker, and the dividend is of 90 cents. In this case, the call buyer will choose to exercise its option, because even though they lose 82 cents on the extrinsic value, they still will be able to capture 90 cents in the dividend, and thus netting 8 cents as a profit. So if you are a short call on this particular ticker, you may be at a high risk of assignment on this. because of the upcoming dividend. Now the question is, how do I find one that what the extrinsic value is? There are two ways to find an extrinsic value. One is look at your trading platform. This is thinkorswim, and on the option chain you can choose the various options, pun intended, to display the fields of extrinsic value like this. So you can choose to display the extrinsic value on your trading platform. And if your trading platform does not support extrinsic value, then the other way to find the extrinsic value is to look at the value of the corresponding put option on the same strike price as your short call option. That will give an approximation of the extrinsic value remaining in the call option. Again, let me make it very clear. If your trading platform does not show the extrinsic value, the alternative way to find extrinsic value on a particular call option is to look at the mid price of the corresponding put option. That put option is equivalent or very close to the extrinsic value remaining in the call option. Then you should compare if the upcoming dividend is more than the value of the put option, that is, if the dividend is more than the amount of extrinsic value remaining in the call option, then that short call is at high risk of assignment. Lastly, we've gone through the exercise process, assignment process. We found out how to figure out if we are at a risk of being assigned. Now the last topic I want to talk about is what to do if I am assigned the stock or if I'm assigned my option. First, if your portfolio can hold the position, then you should sell the option to reduce the delta. For example, if you are assigned on a short put, then you sell a high delta call against the assigned shares. Because you're a short put, you got assigned, means you got a shares on it, then you should sell the corresponding high delta call to make it a covered call and reduce your cost basis. If you are assigned a short call, then you should send a high delta short put. Short call you were assigned means the shares were called away from you, then you should sell a high delta put as a means to acquire the shares that were called away. But if your portfolio cannot hold the position, then you just close it out and move on. All right, so this was the overall process of options exercise, assignment, and what to do if you are assigned an option contract. Thank you for your time. If you have any questions, please write it in comments or email it to optiongig@gmail.com. If you liked what you learned, please help us spread the word so others can also benefit from it.